So I'm going to introduce Rich Pelzer. Rich Pelzer played basketball for us in the early 2000s, and here's where it gets impressive. Two-time WIAC Player of the Year. He's the National Player of the Year. His team won the conference championship in 2004, so we're celebrating the 20th anniversary of that whole championship. He's a member of our Hall of Fame and the WIAC Hall of Fame. After he left River Falls, he played professional basketball. After his career was done playing basketball, that's when the fun stuff really started. He got into the nonprofit world. So he's been spending time in the Twin Cities working with nonprofit organizations to better serve the community. He is a tremendous person. We're proud to call him all in. We're proud to call him a friend. So let's give it up for Rich Pelzer.
I know what it takes to be a student athlete, and I know how hard you all work to get to the spot that you're at. And it probably started with elementary school and high school, having dreams. We had dreams to play pro sports when they were kids. Come on, how's it going to be to play college sports? You're all here with your dreams, and then all of a sudden you find yourself getting recruited. Being a student athlete at a collegiate level is no small feat, so today's really about you. That's a big deal. And it took a lot of work, working with the families, working with the coaches. And then you get here and the work really starts. And for you upper classmen, you know what it takes for the younger classmen, the classmen that have come in. You have another year that you're going to have to exhaust all the time. And it's probably not going to be easy, and that's okay, but you got more in the tank. Too many times I hear people that I played with when I was younger or in college, they'll say, oh man, you're too good in school, man. I wish I would have worked harder when I was in college, or I wish I would have practiced more. And you don't get that time yet. So while you're here, you've got two jobs. Academics. So, athletics. Everybody here has time for those things. You should be devoting all your time. I said we're the champions, and it's a pretty modest thing. Some of y'all are going to be champions. Join the club. It's a great club to be a part of. Some of us aren't, but when you look back, you want to make sure you gave everything you had. All the time, relentlessly. Because you're going to play with them, you're going to be 20 years removed like I am. And it's going to be a theme that the coaches and the faculty and the staff are going to say, hey, man, it's too fast, it's worth it. I only got a few minutes to give you this game, so. On another note, we've got to squeeze some fun out of this game, too, right? We're here to have fun. We're here to enjoy ourselves. But I'm here to tell you, as a proud father, as a former athlete, it's not the wins and losses that you're going to remember. Yeah, competing is great. You're going to do the thing. You're going to tear each other up. You're going to work your fucking ass off. You're going to do all the things you need to do to be successful. But when it's all said and done, the things that you're going to remember is going to be the bus trips, the road trips, chopping it up with your teammates. Parties. I know y'all don't go to party line. Everyone's going to a party line somewhere. That's okay. Right? But those are the things that you're going to remember. Those are the things that you're going to hold dear to you. You know, when you become young adults, when you become parents. And these relationships that you build with each other, if you're lucky, you'll have them for the rest of your lives. Particularly with the faculty. With the staff, the counselor, the chancellor, your teammates are going to be the CEO of a major Rich brings you to Kingdom. That's what Rich is doing. So as you harness all these experiences that we have in each course, you're going to use it later on, I promise you. And it's not going to be the wins and losses. It's going to be those stories, those relationships. And, you know, sports, no matter if you're playing tennis, or basketball, football, as a professional today, I've been a CEO for 2 years. And that education is invaluable. I mean, we're here for our education first and foremost. But the things I use today are the things I learned to use. What do you learn from sports? When to lead, when to fall back, when to get after it, right? How to take direction, how to show up or how to stick. These are all things you learn in sports, no matter what you play. So, I guess where I'm going with this is every sprint counts, every lap counts, every hit counts, every morning workout counts. It's going towards something greater for you later on in life. Extra morning shoot moves to the gym. You know, I wasn't going to dive into this, and I know I've got a couple of minutes, but I lived in the locker room at Target Center for 4 months because I had some stuff going on out of the court that twisted me up. But it was the best thing that ever happened. I sat there and watched Phil every single night, and I snuck in out of the janitors and let me in. I'd sleep downstairs. My day just grew and elevated. And I went from not being heard of ever, all of a sudden being, you know, we didn't have to be without an hour. We were getting recognition. And I hope you find whatever catalyst you have to drive you to that next level, to push you to that next gear, and to look back one day and maybe see, you know, something commemorative of your day or your team, your time here in the Raptors.